Hello and welcome to So Let's Play. In this video here I will talk about triads. How can you learn triads better? Often when we play triads we play them from the root and up to the fifth. But can you play them from the fifth and down to the root? Can you play all the triads that you for example have in the key of G major? So can you play them all over the neck from the fifth and to the root? In G major we have seven triads, so if we look at all the chords that we have in G major, we have a G, we have an A minor, and B minor, and we have C major, and D major, and E minor, and we have F sharp diminished, and G major. So if we shall play the triads, we will take a position. So we can start with this position here, where we have the G here. And the first triad, if we play the first triad from the fifth, in this position here, we will play it from the A. So if we go down to the third and to the root, we'll have a D major. The next triad is C major, because we have D here and then we go back to C and we will start from the G. And the next triad after that will be B minor. So here we start from the fifth F sharp and D and B. And the next triad will be A minor. So here we will start from the fifth E, C, A. And after that, we have G. And then we will start from the fifth, which are D and B and G. And the next triad is the F sharp diminished. And here we will start from the fifth, which are C, and then the third A, and down to the root F sharp. And the next triad is E minor. So here we start from the fifth, which are the B, and then a G, and an E. And after that, we have a D, and here we will start from the fifth, which are A, and then F sharp and D, and the next triad is a C major. Here we start from the G and down to the third E and the root C, and the next triad is a B major, B minor, and here we will start from the F sharp and D and B, and after that we have the A minor where we start from E to C to A, and the next triad F after A minor is G major, and then we go down to G. So, the next position we have is here. So here you can, for example, think A dorian. And you have the G here. And the first triad we can play here is from the note C. So if we take the C and go down a third here, a minor third, and a minor third more, we have a F sharp diminished. And we know that after F sharp diminished, we will have an E minor triad. So after this F sharp diminished triad, we will have an E. So now we start on the fifth here, which is a B. G and E. So here we have the E minor triad, and then the D major, and then C major. After C major, we have B minor, which start here on F sharp, and D and B. And after that, we will have A minor, and then we have G major, and then we have the F sharp diminished, and then we have the E minor and D major, and then we have the C major, and then we have the B minor chord, and then the A minor. Okay, the next position is here around 7th and 10th fret. So we take the tone D here, we have a new triad going down, so it's a G triad now. And as we know, after G, we have F sharp diminished. So now we start on the C. And after F sharp diminished, we will have an E. So now we have to start on the B. And then we will have a D major triad. And after D major, we'll have C major. And after C major, we will have a B minor. And after B minor, we'll have the A minor and G major. And then we have the F sharp diminished and E minor and D major. And then we have the C major and the B minor. The next position we have is here. So it's around 10 and 12th, 13th fret. So if we start here, we have an E here. And if we start from E and go down, we'll have an A minor triad. And we know after A minor, we'll have a G major. So, and after G major, you'll have the F sharp diminished. So here we have the C and A and the F sharp, and after F sharp diminished, we'll have the E minor. We start on the B here, and then the G, after E minor we have the D major, and after D major we'll have C major, and after the C major triad we will have a B minor triad, and then we have the A minor triad and the G major, and after G major we'll have the F sharp diminished. After the F sharp diminished, we'll have E minor and then D major. Okay, and the last position is in this area here. So we have the G here. And here we can start on the G and go down. So we have G down on a minor third and down a major third, then we will get the C major. After the C major going down, it's B minor. So now we will start from the F sharp it was the B minor, and then we have the A minor. And after A minor, we will have a G major. So we start on the G, D here, and B, and G. After the G major, we will have the F sharp diminished. So we have first G, D, G major, sorry, G major, and F sharp diminished. And after F sharp diminished, we will have the E minor. And after E minor, D major and C major. After C major, we will have B minor. And it's here. So first it was C major, and then B minor, and after B minor we have the A minor, and G major, and after this G major here, we will have the F sharp diminished. So we play first G major, and then F sharp diminished from the C here, on the second string, and then we have E minor as the last triad. So it was all the positions. Today we have covered all the triads we have in the key of G major. Of course you will meet the triads in other keys and other scales, so you can also use them there.